Hello, I'm Mike, and in this video, I'll show you start to finish how to build your very first SaaS using no code with Claude Code. Let's dive in. First thing you're going to do is download Node.js. It's really easy, and they have a version for every operating system. I'm on a Mac, so it's easy, but you can do it on Windows too. Just note with Windows, you'll need to do Linux on Windows with WSL. That's a little more complicated. With Mac, you just install and then run the Mac terminal like this. You type in terminal, and there's your terminal. Now, once you've installed Node and it's all up and running, you just enter this simple command here, which I'll put in the description down below. This will take 2 seconds to install Claude Code like that. Next, we're going to run Claude Code for the first time and make sure it's all set up. And to do that, we just type Claude. On the first run, it's simply going to ask you, do you want to use a Claude account with subscription? So if you already have a Claude AI sub, that's perfect, $20 a month or $100 a month for max. Or you can use the Anthropic console, which basically is pay-as-you-go usage. Now, I recommend if you've already got a Claude account or you want to start paying for one, use that because you won't get any unnecessary surprises. I use pay-as-you-go and I try to keep an eye on the billing. You'll see here from the Anthropic pricing page, actually Pro is very reasonable and gives you access to Claude Code in your terminal. But if you pay for Max, you get 5 to 20 times more usage. So if you're doing a lot of building, you might want to consider that. Now, Claude Code is terminal based, meaning you have to type away at the command line, and that can be scary for a lot of people. I'm going to give you one mega tip that will make Claude Code visual so you can see everything that's being done and even edit in a nice little graphical interface rather than working inside the terminal. To do this, you're going to make sure you've downloaded Cursor. It can be pro or free. I use the pro account, and we're going to open a project. Now I just went to a folder in my Mac called Claude Code, and I'm going to create a folder called YT Comments. That'll be the name of my SaaS. Okay, once I've done that, click open, and now you can see visually we are inside here. You don't need to worry about anything too much yet. I'm just going to get rid of this little chat on the right-hand side, and this is basically where you'll see the files appear. So to start, we'll go Terminal, and new terminal, and we'll get something down here. Close down this problems area and just type in Claude here to get Claude Code up and running. And you'll see it's working away. Here it is. It's ready to do things. On the first run, we're going to type /, and it tells you all the commands you can run, and you'll type init like so, and that initializes your project. So Claude Code is now setting up everything it needs to make sure you can work on your brand new SaaS idea. And at some point or other, it's going to ask you if you want to proceed with what it proposes. You just say yes. And it's asked me again, so I'll say yes and don't ask again. Now we're running on autopilot, and you'll notice up here, it created a folder called .claude, a hidden folder with a settings file in there. Okay, now it's creating a Claude markdown file. This is very important. This is where our instructions will go. And you can see actually now it's finished and auto accept edits is on inside Claude Code. So inside this Claude MD file, we can actually start typing in information about our project or our SaaS that we're building. And you can see here, it tells you what the file does. It gives guidance to Claude Code. It gives space to give a project overview here, development commands that may be needed, and any architecture you might want to use. I created something earlier, so let's actually command A and delete everything here, command V, and you'll see I've asked for a YouTube comment analyzer, and it's simply going to be a clean UI, focus on actionable insights. It will use the YouTube red and white color scheme, prioritize fast loading, it will analyze, and it will clear jargon-free language, including ensuring mobile responsiveness and displaying progress indicators all the time along, as we're going to analyze YouTube comments to come up with some awesome ideas. Now we've got that in Claude MD. Make sure you've saved it using Command S on your keyboard or Control S on a PC. And now we're going to go ahead and build the first part of our application. And this is really important to get right. I can't stress enough that you should give a really good prompt up front to get something good. And one more tip is to configure Claude Code for the best success possible. So down here, before I even type my prompt into Claude Code, I'm going to go /config, and there it is. And now we can do all kinds of things and configure inside Claude Code. The most important thing here is I'm going to go to model and change from the default model, which is Claude Sonnet, to Claude for Opus. This is very expensive, but it'll give us the best chance of success. With that done, I'm now going to copy and paste a prompt into the terminal here, and you can see it actually just shows pasted text. But if I actually start a new file here, I'll show you exactly what my prompt is to Claude. You can see I'm asking it to build me a simple but powerful YouTube comment analyzer tool. It takes a YouTube video URL as input, gets all the comments, and then uses AI to identify frequently asked questions, points that are mentioned, follow-up content, and any emotional sentiment. It will generate specific actionable video ideas and present them in a clean, easy-to-read format. So that's what I'm going for. This is the pasted content here. We'll hit enter and we'll let Claude force on it work away on my project. And you can see already it says I'll build a YouTube comment analyzer tool for you. Let me start by planning the project. And you'll see straight away it creates a wonderful to-do list of everything it's got to do to get started. And it doesn't waste any time. It builds this all for me and it starts ticking off its to-do list and highlighting what it's working on as it goes along. Now, here we go. We can already see it's creating a package ready to launch for my nice new SaaS. All I need to do at this stage is drink coffee. Oh, and by the way, at this stage, while we wait, it's worth telling you I just published a tutorial in my premium community about integrating Stripe and a database with your SaaS using MCP servers. It's really easy to follow. It's full and comprehensive with a step-by-step guide and video to go along with it. That's Creator Magic Premium. Prices rise when we hit 350 members with lots of premium features and builders based around the world who are making great things. Okay, let's look at what Claude Code's been up to. And we can see actually the to-do list is pretty much getting ticked off. It's just writing the README to say what it's done. And of course, if we open this README file inside Cursor, you'll be able to see everything that Claude Code has worked on. It's made a beautiful README file. It tells me how to set it up and put my API keys in should I need to, and even start the server. And look at this, finally it's editing the Claude MD file to modify it with project-specific guidelines based on what it's done, and it's done all of that. And now if we go back to the Claude MD file, you'll see it's got a lot lengthier with exact architecture ideas. So that means as our project grows, Claude will always refer back to this file and never hallucinate and mess up your project, which is great. Okay, it really was as simple as that. It seems to have wrapped up. So now it's telling us how to use things, and it gives us a simple 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If this works in just one prompt, I'll be amazed. This is Claude for Opus in action. So first in Cursor, I'll hit the plus up here to start a new terminal window. I can swap between them using these tabs here, and I'll copy the first command, which is the npm install command to get this installed ready to run. We'll run that in the same directory as my YouTube comments app, and well, that was quick, it's done. Next, it tells me I need to copy env example to .env and add API keys. So here is the .env.example. You'll see here, this is what we need, a YouTube API key and an OpenAI API key. So first, I will copy this file by hitting copy there in the menu, and then I'll command V and paste it, and then just simply make sure we rename it to be called .env without the example at the end. Now we can enter our API keys here. These are private, so don't reveal them. First, I'll use a project I've got here already in Google Cloud, and I'll create an API key. And we'll just copy and paste that one there. And nicely, Claude Code has actually told me the URL I need to go to generate the API key, in case I didn't know. The same with this one for OpenAI. Let's command and click. And we'll create a key called ytcomments, like so. Copy that and paste that into the OpenAI API key area. That's a long key, isn't it? Okay, next up, we're ready to run npm start, and then I think we'll be ready to access the server. So let's run that command here in the command line, and look at that, YouTube comment analyzer running on localhost colon 3000. Let's command click, and boom, look at this. Wow, that was brilliant. A one-shot YouTube comment analyzer. Transform audience feedback into your next viral video. But the question is, will it work? Let's try. So here I've got my Creator Magic YouTube channel, and let's grab my VO3 video, copy the link address, go to my brand new one-shotted YouTube comment analyzer with Claude Code, paste in the URL. Aha, yes, one more time. YouTube data API V3 has not been used. Well, it's nice that Claude gave me a full over. Again, this is human error, not AI error. I need to basically set up in my Google Cloud Console the ability for this API key to access the YouTube data library. And to do that, I'll go to library and we'll search for YouTube. And then we'll search for YouTube data. Yep, that's the one we need. There it is. Beautiful. Click into it and click enable. Should be as simple as that. And once this spinning circle stops spinning, we're good. Let's go back to the analyzer. Let's copy that URL, refresh, and one more time. Now this should work. And look at this. It's spinning around, meaning it is making a call. Sadly, we've still got failed to analyze comments, so this is where we'll go back to Claude Code. And you know what? Now that I've used Opus to make the initial prototype, I'm going to switch this model down to the default model because I don't need to spend that much money when I've now made the MVP. So I'll paste in the details there. There's my pasted text. Error, please fix. And we'll get Claude Code to hopefully go ahead, explore what's occurring there with my API and fix it so that this app does work. And we can see it's an OpenAI API error here, and it's the response format that's causing the problem. It's not supported. So it's updating the code to handle JSON, which is, of course, the feedback we get from the API. You can see all the edits it's making here, which is absolutely fine. And it seems to be done. It didn't take that long. It just told me it's made some changes. Run the tool again, and it should work. Great stuff. So I'll command C out of this, restart with npm start. Now we'll go back to this YouTube comment analyzer. We'll refresh and paste in that URL one more time. The tension is mounting. Wow, and look at that, it worked. My only VO3 tutorial you need has had 11.3K views, 47 comments, 0.42% engagement. It gives me a sentiment breakdown, which is incredible. Top themes, frequently asked questions, high priority pain points, here they are. Oh my goodness me. Answering your top two questions. How to automate with VO3? What is the cost of VO3? How to fix cost of VO3. Wow. Clearing up common misconceptions about VO3 only allowing 8-second videos. Detailed insights. Look at this. Oh my goodness me. It has totally broken down all my comments, attributed likes to those comments as well, and I can even export the analysis. Oh my goodness me. And it's given me a markdown file, and I can open the markdown file, and it's literally broken down everything I need to do for a future video about VO3. This is really cool. Remember, I made that in one prompt with Claude Code and the Claude 4 Opus model. I did need to troubleshoot a little bit of problem with the API, but it was fixed in one prompt. I'm at an MVP of a very, very legitimate SaaS. But finally for this tutorial, I really like the look of this already, but maybe I want it to look a bit different. Maybe I want this to look like YouTube Studio. So I'll go to YouTube Studio and I'll go ahead and take a screenshot of exactly what it looks like. Now that's done, we'll go back to Claude Code and say, make the UI look like this. And yes, you can indeed drag and drop from anywhere, in this case my desktop, screenshots into Claude Code, and it will actually see what you're referencing. And now we can see here it's designing. I can see this is a YouTube Studio community comments interface with dark theme. I'll update the UI to match this. And there we go, it's changing all the CSS, which is the look of my app. Okay, and it was that easy. It's told me all the updates it's made. So I can get back to my browser. I can hit the refresh button and wow. Okay, this is looking much more like YouTube Studio. How funny, it's even made the YouTube logo up there. This is insane. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead. Let's drag my latest video here and then we'll go back to the app. We'll paste this in. And again, drum roll please as the analysis takes place. Let's see how good this looks now with my new updated UI, all from a screenshot. Now, you're probably wondering how much it costs to make that little MVP app. Well, the best thing is when you do Control C and then Control C again, it gives you a total cost summary of your session. $3.06 is all it costs me to make a SaaS. This is really cool stuff. I've been doing this with my other great project, Pimp My Thumb, where you can generate improved versions of thumbnails. And I used Stripe just the other week to start charging for credits. And for a while, I've had Superbase integrated in the back end. So it really is a SaaS that I've built out in a number of days, not even weeks or months as it would have taken in the past. Claude Code, I really think, is the best option out there right now for creating an MVP SaaS, launching it, getting customers, making a bit of money. This is an incredible time to be coding. And the best thing is, you don't even need to code. There is no code involved. Once you understand how Claude Code works, you'll see that it's powerful. Can't wait to see what you create. We're discussing all of this in my community and in the comments down below. Thanks so much for watching. And YouTube is showing a video on your screen now. You should watch next. Thanks.